Hope you're doing well this morning. I'm quickly just reading some of the comments. Marie says, you were right about the solar flare. I am South England and we have a red alert for an aurora. Oh wow, that's gonna be amazing. Jamie says we might even see some southern lights in Australia too. Yeah, we need to keep an eye out for the times. Because it's hard to sort of work out exactly what time it's going to happen. Hopefully it's going to be nighttime so we can see it nicely. Good morning, everybody. So Ronnie says, what am I doing wrong? I'm using Artco Blue masking fluid. Redid pics as it ripped the paper coming off and ruined my paper and the drawing of my mantis. Did it all again and the same thing happened. Artco Blue masking fluid. What paper are you using, Ronnie? It shouldn't do that. You might... I don't know why it's doing that. Jamie says she remembers seeing auroras once when she was about 10. Wow. It would be amazing to see. Okay, Marie's saying that the masking fluid has to be very dry before you remove it. Yep, it does. Ronnie says she actually saw the sun flare happen. She was sitting watching the sun through squinted eyes. Next thing I knew, there was a huge flash. Rang my son and told him, and he rang me back with the news later. Oh, that's cool. Wow, you're squinting and looking at the sun, that's crazy. I cannot look at the sun. But if you look at solarham.net, the website, they've got some really amazing videos of these solar flares. You left it overnight. You're using the blue one. I don't know, I'm wondering if maybe you're leaving it too long. Maybe your paper is too thin for it. Maybe you're overdoing the masking fluid. I'm not sure why that's happening. Maybe test it on various types of paper, if you have any. And see how that goes for you. Okay. So we're going to carry on with the praying mantis. So we've done a fair bit on the back side section of it, just with starting to define details and things like that. So we are going to carry on with that and finish up those details. So the section of the tail, or the bottom, the lower back, has sorts of little pieces of orange and yellow in there, which I haven't taken out. But before I apply that, I want to use some of the white pencil first to make some of those areas a bit lighter, because they're just a little bit too dark at the moment. Yeah, Ronnie, I'm sorry that happened to you. I think maybe test it on various papers to see if it's the masking fluid that's just too strong maybe, or if it's the paper. So I'm using the Archer's watercolor paper for this one, and it is 220 GSM. So we'll see how it goes. Should be about the same as the Fabriano. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that lightened that up a little bit for me, making room for me to add some of the orangey sort of colors. So using my swatch to check, I think I'm going to use number 1032. This is the perfect color for it. So 1032 is burnt ochre. I think it is. I'm just going to sharpen that. Your paper's 300 GSM, which is really thick. I wonder if the moisture has an effect on the surface of the paper, or it just makes it a little more fragile when you apply something even more wet to it. I'm just getting my hair out the way. Ooh. I'm a bit on go slow this morning. Okay, so I've sharpened my burnt ochre, and now I'm going to add some of those red tones. I'm not using much pressure. I am using the point, but very light pressure. Now I need an even oranger tone, a more orange tone. I'm going to go with 918, which is orange. Okay, then I'm going to use a very, very light yellow. So I'm going to use cream, PC 914. And then if you want to know why I'm picking certain colors, make sure you're looking at your reference. So I wanted to continue the stream this morning on the same link as I used yesterday, and I thought I could do that, but I can't. So I had to create a new video link. So it will still be in two parts, but at least the video quality is so much better than what I was able to do before. To keep working on detailing that area. So what I will do is grab a white paint marker using these Uniposco 0.5, what does it say, 0.7 mil paint markers, and they're really good for just little highlighted spots. Like I have, there's a tiny little highlighted spot on the tip of that area, so it just makes it look shiny, super shiny. And then what we will do is some of the pink areas as well, because it looks moist actually and highlighted, we can add some of this marker too. And then if you overdo the marker, it's easy for you to softly scratch it off with either your nail or another pencil before it dries over a period of days. You'd want to do that. So it just adds some amazing little highlights. So that's also something that you would usually do very last. You're doing sort of little touch-ups everywhere. But I guess I got a little bit excited and I wanted to use it now. So now I'm going to use my Process Red PC994. And paying attention to small individual areas now. So if you're watching on your computer screen, make sure to set it to 1080p in settings. Watch it through YouTube. It's better if you watch it through YouTube. And then you can make it full screen. The quality should be really good. I guess it also depends on your connection. If you have a good connection, you'll be able to see the good quality. I like that. I'm gonna blend with my solvent. Ronnie is asking, did you do art before work in progress? I'm not sure I understand what you mean. Are you asking if I did the praying mantis before I did this as a live stream? Oh, you mean working in pencils, not work in progress. No, I think I sort of, I did art in school. I know that's funny. I did art in school, but I didn't really take it much further until 2014. I know I've always loved art, and it's something that I've just always enjoyed, but I have tried a bit of acrylic painting and things like that in school, but never really, never really explored it to the fullest. And I didn't keep anything, which is such a shame, so I can't show you guys how over time I started improving and what the differences were. So now I'm going to use the Grade Lavender PC 1026. Stephanie says, sorry to laugh. It just makes her think of the text where the mom sends to her daughter that an aunt died and put LOL thinking it meant lots of love. You know, it's weird. A lot of people did or do think that that's what it means. But yeah, it means laugh out loud. I guess it makes sense you could use it for both. How can you say which one is really the right one? Okay, so I'm covering the entire body here where the very light sort of wings are. With this color, and then I'm going to define the details a little bit further once I've blocked in this color. Okay, now I want to blend that. because you can really see the texture of the paper. So I'm gonna add a few of these layers until the texture is gone. Okay, so Stephanie says, apparently the solvent doesn't affect the paint pen. Do you always continue to blend your layers with solvent? And when you do, and when do you stop blending? That's a question I get a lot, but it's a very difficult thing to answer because it depends on when I'm ready to stop blending or layering. So it's hard to know when to stop, I guess. So you have to decide that for yourself. But generally I add about two or three layers. What I mean by that is I have my layers of pencil and then solvent, and then second layer of pencils and then solvent, and then third layer of pencils and then solvent. So I generally tend to stick around three complete layers or cycles of layers in that sense. I don't know if that helps. But if it's something that's got a lot of detail in it, it may need a lot more attention. Oh, I've been forgetting to record this with my DSLR. Far out. That's not good. I need to replace the battery. Okay, so now that I have my foundation color down, I am going to start adding the details of the wing using my white pencil because it's a very, very light wing. So when I use white, I always use the Prismacolor white because the wax white base pencil is more opaque than the oil base pencil. So now I'm just going to use that to define the patterns in the wing. So this wing goes from about there to there. You see how the white shows up? So you wouldn't get that right with your oil-based pencil. So now I'm going to use this to define the patterns in the wings. So you want a very, very sharp pencil. You don't want to use pressure because you don't want to break that point. When it starts losing its sharpness, you sharpen it again. See, my hand's not going green, which is good. Well, it's a teeny bit green, but not much. So the, because I always lean my hand against the drawing, so at least I know the fixative, or the workable fixative worked well enough to not make the pan pastels spread around. So this wing goes like that. It's starting to look like, it is starting to look like wings, which is good. Jamie says, I feel like I'm cheating on you, Sheldine. I'm watching you do your praying mantis while following a how to draw water in pencils tutorial by Lisa. No, Jamie, that's good. Do it. You want to learn from as many artists as possible, and Lisa's a friend of mine, so I am all into helping other artists and learning from as many artists as you can, so don't feel that way. It's all good. I'd encourage you to actually go and subscribe to different art teachers and that, to explore different mediums and try new things. You have to do that if you want to sort of find your own way. So by exploring different things, only then can you figure out what works for you and what doesn't. Yeah, the white pencil really makes a difference, doesn't it? And I think with a section like this, many people go too dark. So it's good to have your light sort of foundation color, and then if you don't layer too heavily, you'd be able to use your white pencil to define those little details. So before I continue with the details in the wings, I am going to do that little green section on the back. So using the kelp green PC1090, I'm going to put different pressures on there, never an extreme amount of pressure, to create different values. So that I'm establishing the darker areas and the lighter areas of the green. Then I want to add a little bit of Tuscan Red, PC937. And then I actually want a brighter green. So I think I'm going to go with apple green, PC912. And add that green as a light layer in between the green I just placed down. There's a little bit of orange in there, so I'm going to use my orange PC918. And then using the darker green, marine green PC988. And establish the darker values. And then using indigo blue, PC901. Those edges are very defined and dark, so you can almost outline them. Just not the whole, don't outline all of it, because then it looks like you've just cut and pasted something on there. Okay, then we're going to blend that in. I'm going to take my white pencil, make sure it's got a very sharp point. Looking at that highlight that's on there. that green to be even brighter. So I'm going to use Chartreux PC989 and make that green pop out a bit more. Okay, so when I hear that click on my DSLR, I know I need to immediately record it again, because if I just leave it for a few minutes, then I forget. There we go. Thank you. Okay, so I feel like I can extend it just a smidge more. I'm going to use the Green Ochre PC1091. And leave it at that, because I can see myself overdoing it. So for now, it's just going to stay like that. Okay, now in this wing area, there are still some areas of greater value. So I'm going to use some grays. So I'm going to use PC1061, which is a 10% cool gray, and darken up some of the areas that are a little more gray. That's already giving it quite a nice effect. Use a bit of a pink tone, so blush pink PC9028. Nanette's asking me what made me want to draw this. I don't know, I saw it and then I think the colors do have some part of it. I did love the colors and I love greens. And I think the background also just, I thought the two contrasting colors just made, had such a nice effect. So yeah, it would have been fun to draw. I never really have a reason. I just see something I like and then I decide, okay, let's do it. Okay, so now we just have to add one darker color to the wings, and then I think we are good. So I'm going to use 70% Cool Grey, PC1065. And just defining between some of the real light little patterns on the wings, some of those areas are a bit darker. So I feel like I'm going just a little bit too dark, but I'm gonna be careful. I just spat on that. Okay. Okay, so just to make that die down just a little bit, I'm going to lightly blend it with my solvent. It just brings in the surrounding white colors that we've put down. And sort of mixes in with a grey, and then the grey isn't quite as strong. And it sort of gives it a little bit of a translucent illusion. So that is perfect for wings, because that's exactly what we want. Because wings are translucent. So they look cool. They look cool on the computer screen, I think. So from what you guys can see, I quite like it. Oh, I've got tea, I keep forgetting. What are we going to work on next? Let's work on the back of the head and the neck. So using the process red, PC 994, So I create almost little tiny little scribble patterns so that I'm creating an illusion of a texture. I never worry about getting those little textures exactly right, because that's just not fun and a waste of time. You don't have to do that. That already gives it a nice effect. Okay, I think I'm just gonna work a little bit everywhere instead of piece by piece and start working on various details. If I'm using a particular color that I know I'm gonna use again somewhere else, I'm just gonna block it in. So this is also something else that's personal preference. You decide where you wanna start and how you wanna move about your drawing. There's no set way. It's usually a decision that you'll make as you draw. It's not something that you would decide beforehand. Okay, using the lavender PC934. And block in more values. So I'm going to do the same thing on the legs. I'm going to block in my colors and then use my white to define the sort of textures on the legs. So that is going to save you a lot of time in trying to draw in those textures. Then using the blush pink PC928. It's the area, it's more pink than it is purple. Some of this in between here. Using my dark purple PC931, you can see part of the back leg coming through this way, creating a sort of dark shadow. So the little antennas on top of the praying mantis's head, I use the same color to sort of pinpoint them. Okay, now I'm going to blend and then reassess. So Ronnie says she just did a test on the masking fluid. She thinks she was putting it on too thick. Comes off now, but leaves a terrible blue stain on the paper. Totally useless product for this project. I'm so sorry to hear that. You might have to go with this sort of masking fluid instead, like a yellowish tone one. instead of the blue one. Name of the masking fluid, I already forgot. Is this one? It's called National Art Material Masking Fluid. I'm pretty sure you can get her on eBay. Oh, I love the colors. It looks so cool. Okay, so now I'm going to use the white to add the detailing like I did in the wings. I'm also going to use the white for the spiky bits that come off the legs. I'm just going to check. I think someone's at the door. Must have been someone at the door. Okay, so carrying on with the white. I mean, must have been someone walking past. I'm not even thinking about what I'm saying before I say it. Honey, Tyler, what are you doing? What are you doing? In and out, in and out. I'm gonna lie here. Go lie down. Pick a spot. slowly starting to take shape beautifully. I really like that. Okay, so for some grays, I'm gonna use the Cool Gray PC1065. Can see with my freehand I made the neck very short, but there's nothing I can do about it now. Mojean's asking, what have you been having your workshop students draw? All basic things. There aren't many people that have very little or any experience with colored pencils, so I really have to stick to basics. So it's real beginner classes. We don't really get to finish a drawing, so we practice layering and blending, and then maybe we end up drawing a fruit or flower, but I haven't had the time to do enough workshops for me to start planning an intermediate class. So it's really simple workshops. I'm going to blend some of that in so that some of the harsh colors don't look quite as dominating, especially the gray that I just applied. Now, I'm gonna use my white paint marker to add the white highlights on the head. I'm going to put them where they belong, all of them. So some of them are going to be too thick, but I'll show you how I sort of make it die down a little so it's not as overpowering. Highlights in the wing are just sort of like personal choice. I wanted those highlights to be a bit stronger. Now, just using a sharp white pencil, I might just go over some of the highlights, and that'll make them die down a little. You can scratch them off with using your pencil if you choose to. That's if you just made them a bit too strong in some places. Which I don't mind. I really like that. It's looking glossy and shiny and three-dimensional, and I think that's looking really cool. So now I'm going to do the leaf, and then we would do the feet. So I actually want to cover the feet with the green. I might just use whatever's left on my pan pastel. Because the leaf, the legs are just so teeny tiny. Okay, now I have to spray that. Out. Now we're going to focus on the greens of the leaf. Actually, I'm just going to do this vein here and leave the leaf alone and do the little feet and then call it done. So you could go as far as just adding little highlights in the leaf, and you can go as far as you want with the leaf, but I actually don't mind it as it is, so I'm going to leave it be. So using my Apple Green PC912, I want to put this color into the vein of the leaf. And then using PC120 Sap Green Light, I'm going to put in that nice light color in this section of the vein. If you're not sure about colors, make sure to use your swatches. Then I'm going to use Pale Sage PC1089. Then I'm going to use Marine Green PC988, and I'm just going to go on the side of the vein to make it pop out a bit more. Using dark green PC908. Stephanie's asking, what could you use if you didn't have a paint marker? You could use the titanium white if you have the brush and pencil titanium white, or you could use gouache, you could use paint with a fine little brush. Yeah, or just see how far you can get with your white wax base pencil. It won't be as bright, but you can only use what you have. Okay, I really have to finish the leaves. I can't just do the vein. It's not gonna look right. So I'll establish where the lighter areas are. So using the Charo, I think, I'm not sure how you pronounce this, PC989, I can see sort of where those little veins are. So I'm going to use this color to help me establish them. Okay, using apple green, PC912. Stephanie says it's pronounced chartreuse. Okay, chartreuse is that light green we just used, and now we're using apple green, PC912. Thanks, Stephanie. Now I'm just going to roughly block in colors. I'm not worried about details or anything. Then using marine green, PC988. Then using dark green, PC908. I'm still using dark green. I want to sort of create the illusion of a dark shadow under the lighter vein, and that's going to give it a little bit more form. Thank you. Okay. And then I'm going to use a piece of tissue. I'm going to dip the point into my solvent. So just fold it like that. Dip the point into your solvent. So just the very tip, you can barely see. And then I'm going to blend it in like this. So this is another way you could do your background if you don't have pan pastels. Lay down your colors and then blend it smooth using a piece of tissue. Okay, so that's giving you the look of a leaf. You can sort of see the veins. It's giving a little bit of shape. And you can go further with that if you choose to. I'm not, because I have a few things to do, so I might worry about it another day. So I am going to do the legs. And then I'm going to call this drawing done, I think. I'm using Kelp Green PC1090. Sorry, I'm just going ahead without even saying what I'm doing. Dark green again, PC908. This just establish that shadow again. I think I might even add a little bit of indigo blue for the shadow. Beautiful. Blend that in a little. And I've just lost the shadow again. Do it again. That will do. It's a hint of a shadow over there. Now I'm going to use the white to do the legs. Some freaky looking feet. a little bit of the burnt ochre. Bit of yellow ochre, PC942. Okay, back to the burnt ochre. To the yellow ochre, PC942. And then just to make things pop out a little bit more, I'm going to use my white paint marker. Use the pale sage PC1089 to make those white, really bright markers die down a bit. Highlight on me. There we have it. I might just use a little bit of the how was it pronounced? I've already forgotten. Chartreuse, I think. Yes, chartreuse. PC989. Just for this back leg foot thing. That's better. A bit on this one too. I like it. Okay, so I could add more detail to the leaf if I wanted to, but I am gonna call it a day, and this is it. So I'm gonna remove the border. Let me sign it, actually. So I'm gonna use, I'll use the white pencil. And I'll sign it here. Let's go. Teeny little signature. So it's not too overpowering. So I'm going to remove the border, so this is the best part. Seeing how nice and clean it looks afterwards. Actually, let me quickly just spray again. Wait a few seconds. Okay, so next week is early morning, so 3 a.m. my time, to do a stream for those in the UK, or those that sort of fit in with that timeline. And that one, we're going to do also something that's got a beautiful color, and we're going to be doing a sea slug. So that one just looks so amazing, and it's such an easy little pattern to use, and it's just a real easy image, because even if you make slight mistakes, it doesn't matter, because no one really knows what the details of a sea slug looks like. So it's going to be really fun. Oh, ho, ho. Look how nice and clean it looks. Excuse me. Okay, so that is the praying mantis done. It looks really cute. I'm quite happy with it. I did make a mistake with the neck, so the neck looks a bit funky because it's not long enough, and I made it too bulky. But that's okay. The more you do it, the more you sort of learn from these sorts of things. So this will obviously be available to you guys whenever you want. And I'll put a time lapse using my DSLR. I looked at the quality of yesterday's video and it is good enough. There's no point in me uploading a massive file that's 5 hours long for something that you've already got such a high quality thing for. So I'll create a time lapse video out of it, but the high quality videos you guys can watch on Patreon in real time, and you guys can obviously skip ahead if you are getting bored or if you've already done a certain part of it. Marjean says, you are a terrific artist and excellent teacher. Thank you. And Stephanie agrees. Thank you, guys. I do enjoy doing this, and I appreciate the fact that you guys are taking something out of this. And hopefully the real-time videos aren't too boring. I know a lot of people won't go back and watch these videos because they're too boring. But the whole point of these videos is so that you guys can try it as well. So how... trying to do a 5 hour drawing from a half an hour tutorial, I don't think is enough information. So that is why I do it in this way. And because it's a video, you can always fast forward if it's too slow. So that is my sort of view on the whole thing. Sometimes I do get people say your videos are way too long, or they just get too boring. But the whole point is to teach, and for those who are viewing the video to try it. So if you're not doing that, then of course it's going to be boring. And you shouldn't be watching. Okay. So I might see some of you next week, because it should be your morning. I think it's like between 8 and 10 a.m. your time for the UK stream, which will be about 7 or 8 p.m. their time, which makes it about 3 a.m. my time. It's so confusing trying to work out all these time frames to work for everybody. But yeah, I'm excited about doing the slug. It's going to be fun. Same sort of concept. Pan pastel background. Main subject matter. I might even use a bit of pan pastels in the main subject matter. But I'll see how we go. And probably use a lot of these pinks that we used today as well. So if you guys want to try that too, then go for it. Otherwise, you can always see it at another time. Marjean says she'll be there. You have been to almost all of them. It's crazy. Okay, guys, thank you for joining me today, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.